Dear listener, welcome to my channel. In my previous videos, I have explained basic concept of association rule mining like support, confidence, then a priori algorithm, concept of frequent, closed and maximal item set. All these concepts were covered with the various example. Topic of this video is various ways to improve a priori algorithm. A priori algorithm is an influential algorithm for mining frequent item set for Boolean association rule. It uses prior knowledge of frequent item set properties. It uses k frequent item set to find k plus 1 item set. It is based on three concepts: frequent item set, a priori property, and join operation. Disadvantages of a priori: requires many database scan. As the a priori algorithm is iterative, so in every iteration we require to make the scan of the entire database. Assume transaction database is memory resident. To overcome this drawback of the a priori algorithm, there are various ways in which the a priori, that is performance of the a priori, can be improved. You should have knowledge of a priori algorithm to understand the ways to improve a priori algorithm. You can watch my previous videos on a priori algorithm with examples. So these are the way in which, by which we can improve the efficiency of a priori algorithm. First is hash based technique, transaction reduction, partitioning, dynamic item set counting, sampling. First technique, hash based technique. Hash table is used as a data structure. First iteration is required to count support of each item set. From second iteration, efforts are made to enhance the execution of a priori by utilizing hash table concept. Hash table minimizes the number of items saved generated in second iteration. So this is the way in which we can improve the efficiency. In second iteration, that is two item set generation, for every combination of two items, we map them into diverse bucket of hash table structure and implement the bucket count. If the count of bucket is less than minimum support count, we remove them from the candidate set. So all these steps can be easily understood with the help of example. T1 to T9 transactions are there and the items are from I1 to I5. So first T1 transaction indicates that in that transaction, the customer purchased I1, I2 and I5 items. So in this way, all transactions are listed. From this table, we generate the C1. So C1 item set and their respective support count. So we require to count how many times that I1 is present from the database and write down the count. So I1 is present for 6 times. Similarly, we require to go for the all items. So in this way, we are creating the table. Now here, minimum support count is 3. Order of items is I1 equal to 1, I2 equal to 2, I3 equal to 3, and I4 equal to 4, and I5 is equal to 5. Now, from C1, we are directly generating the L2 using the hash function. So before using the hash function, we require to give the order of items. So generally, the order of items is given in chronological fashion. So that's why I1 is 1, I2 is 2, I3 is 3, and I4 is 4, and I5 is 5. Now we require to use a hash function. Hash function is not fixed. Depending on our requirement or depending on our size of the database, our hash function modifies. So this is the basic form of the hash function. So hash function is order of first into 10 plus order of second, and their addition is to be taken as a mod of 7. So 7 is used because 7 is a prime number. Now here, after that, we again scan the database to find out the two item set combination. So I1, I2, I1, I3, I1, I4, up to I4, I5. After that, we write down the count, how many times that particular combinations appears in our original database. Now, we are applying the hash function. So this hash function gives a result, and we require to keep this item set combination into that particular bucket. As mod 7 is there, means our bucket numbers are from 0 to 6. So 1 into 10 plus 2. So I1, I2. So order of I1 is 1. So 1 into 10. Plus order of I2 is 2, so 1 into 10 plus 2 mod 7, which is equal to 5. I1, I3, the first becomes 1 and the order of I3 is 3, so we are getting the result 6. I1, I4, 1 into 10 plus 4 mod 7, so we are getting the answer 0. So in this way, we are getting the answer. Now see the combination I3, I4, as it is not present in table, so we are getting the null here. So there is no need to keep into that particular bucket. I4, I4, we are getting the I4, I5, we are getting the null, so there is no need to keep into the bucket. So in this way, we are generating, using the hash function, we are keeping this particular item set combination into the particular bucket number. Now just see here, I1, I2 present for 4 times and it is stored in bucket number 5. See bucket number 5, it is present for 4 times and combination is I1, I2 4 times. Now in this way we require to write down all the items or layer 2 item set into that particular bucket and write down the that count. So here for example, I1, I2 is present for 4 times. Next is I1, I3 present for 4 times and it is keeping bucket number 6. So I1, I3 bucket number 6 4 times present. So in this way we require to write down all the combination. Now here see the bucket number 0. Bucket number 0 comes twice, that is one with the I1, I4 and one with the I3, I5, and they are present for one time. So I1, I4 and I3, I5 and they are present for one time. Here our minimum support count is 3. So we require to pick up the bucket which satisfy the minimum support criteria. Now here only the buckets that gets qualified as the 4, 4 and 4 because they are greater than or equal to 3. So in the L2 we are taking which items? Only I2, I3 4 times, then I1, I2 4 times and I1, I3 4 times. So in this way from C1 to L2 drastically the number of possible combination reduces and this will give the improvement in the a priori algorithm. So advantages: reduce the number of scans and remove large candidates that cause high input and output cost. Second is transaction reduction. Transaction that does not contain any frequent K item set cannot contain any frequent K plus 1 item set. Therefore, such a transaction can be marked or removed from further consideration. These steps can be easily understood with the example. For example, 4 transactions are there, these are the items. Now this table is converted into the Boolean table. So T1, T2, T3, T4 items are from I1 to I5. Whenever item is present, we mark with the 1 and when it is not present, we mark with the 0. So in the first transaction, I3 and I4 is absent, so we are keeping 0, 0. So in this way, we are converting this table into this table. After that, our minimum support count is equal to 2. So therefore, as minimum support count is equal to 2, so we require to check row and column and find out the entry. If our summation of the that particular row or column, if it is less than or equal to minimum support count, we require to remove that. For example, T1, summation of the T1 is 3, our support count is 2, which is greater than or equal to support count, we allow first row. In this way, we allow the second row, third row and fourth row. We allow the first row because when we take the addition of the first row, we are getting the 2, which is greater than or equal to 2. But we see the I5. Now in the I5 column, we are getting only addition 1, and which is less than our minimum support count. So we delete this I5. So we are getting the resultant table that T1, T2, T3, T4 and column as I1, I2, I3 and I4. Now, next we are going for 2 item set generation. So I1, I2, I1, I3, I1, I4, I2, I3, I2, I4 and I3, I4. Here T1 and T2, T3, T4. Here we exclude the I5. Now here again we check the row and each row and each column and find out their summation should be greater than or equal to 2. So here I1, I3 summation is 1, I1, I4 summation is 1, T1 summation is 1 and T3 summation 1. So they are not satisfying our minimum support, so we remove that. So after the removing, we are getting only 2 rows and these 2 columns are deleted from the table. So we are getting the combination. After that, to generate the 3 item set, we are using the join property of a priori algorithm. So by join property, we can't combine I1, I2 with anyone and similarly I3, I4 with anyone. Only combination is possible with the I2, I3 and I2, I4. So join operation of I2, I3 and I2, I4 gives the result I2, I3, I4, T2 and T4. It is present in both and we are getting 1. This is qualified because the addition of that particular column is 2. So here by seeing the table, we can see that I2, I3, I4 combination is present for 2 times. Third method is partitioning. Any item set that is potentially frequent in database must be frequent in at least one of the partitions of the DB. So this method requires the scan of the original database for 2 times. Now these are the phase 1 and phase 2. So what is the advantage of this? This algorithm can be executed in parallel fashion. Transaction in D, then divide the transaction in D into the non-overlapping partition. Find frequent item set local to each partition. That is, each partition can be executed in parallel fashion. Combine result to form a global set of candidate item set. Find global frequent item set among the candidates. frequent item set indeed. These steps can be easily understood with the help of example. Now six transactions are there and five numbers of items are there, and they are represented in Boolean fashion. Here, as six transactions are there, here database is divided into three partition. So first partition contains T1, T2, second partition contains T3, T4, and third partition contains T5, T6. Now here we are using the support of 20%. So we are keeping the same support at the local as well as global level. So support of 20% for two records means what? That item should be present for one time. And the support of 20% for all six records means what? That item should be present for two times. So for first each partition, we are using the threshold of 20%, means that item should be present for one time. Now see here, T1, T2, T3, T4, T5 and T6 transactions. Now item set I1, I5, I2, I4. So in this way transactions are written. Now this is the first scan of the database, support of 20%, and minimum support is 1, because 20% for two records is 1. Now here we can see that this is the I1 we are getting for one time, I2 we are getting for one time, because this is a T1 and T2 is nothing but the one partition, I4 we are getting one time, I5 we are getting one time, then combination of I1 and I5 we are getting for one time, I2, I4 we are getting for one time. Then we require to apply the similar operation for the second partition. So in the second partition, we are getting the count for I2, I3, I4, I5 as 1, and the count for I4, I5 and I2, I3 is 1. In the third partition, we are getting the count for I2, I3, I4 and I5 as 1, and we are getting the combination of I2, I3, 1, I3, I4, 1, I2, I4, 1 and the 3 combination, that is I2, I3, I4 as a 1. Now we require to make the second scan on the entire database. Now we require to take the union of all three partitions. So mini support is 20%. Now when we take the support as a 20% for entire database, so our that record should be present, or that item set combination should be present for greater than or equal to 2 times. Now here these are removed from our second scan, that is I1 equal to 1, because our support count is 2. Then I1 I5 combination cut, I4 I5 combination cut, I3 I4 combination is cut, and this combination is cut. So which is shortlisted? I2 I3, I4 I5, I2 I4 and I2 I3. This is nothing but the partitioning method in which we are using only the two scan of the original database. So in this way the a priori can be improved. Fourth method is dynamic item set counting. It is an algorithm which reduces the number of passes made over the data while keeping the number of items which are counted in any pass relatively low. The technique can add new candidate items at any mark start point of the database during the scanning of the database. So this step can be easily understood again with the example. Four transactions are given, T1, T2, T3, T4, AB, ABC. There is no items taken in the T4 transaction, so we are represented in the Boolean fashion. ABC, T1, T2, T3, T4. Now minimum support is 25% and M is equal to 2. Now M is nothing but what? We are making the pass of the database for 2 times. So here we are in the first pass, that is we are just taking the T1, T2, and in the second pass we are taking the T3, T4. So that is nothing but what? M equal to 2. That is we divide our entire database into 2 partition. Now here the 4 concepts are used: solid box, solid circle, dash box and dash circle. Now first we start with the dash circle. What is dash circle? It is nothing but the suspected infrequent item set we still are counting and who are below minimum support. So this is nothing but by dash circle. Dash box means what? Suspected frequent item set, an item set that are we still counting and that exceed the minimum support, means whatever that they are greater than or equal to minimum support. Solid circle, confirm infrequent item set, and solid box, confirm frequent item set. Now here the latex structure for before the transaction start. Now empty item set is marked with a solid box. So when we start, we are making this as empty and we are making as a solid. All but one item set are marked with the dash circle. Now see, we start with the dash circle. Dash circle is converted into dash box if they are confirmed frequent. They are converted into the square bracket, otherwise they remain as a solid circle. Now see, when we make the read the database in which we are reading the first two records, so that is nothing but m equal to 1. Initially, before reading any record from the database, our situation or our counters are a equal to 0, b equal to 0, c equal to 0. So we are making as a dash circle because they are not satisfied still our minimum support count. Now minimum support count is 25%. That is nothing but the item should be present for one time, because four transactions are there and support is 25% means that particular item or item set present for one time. So when before reading the database, our counters are a equal to 0, b equal to 0 and c equal to 0. So this is nothing but solid, this is represented by the dash circle because their minimum support count is not still satisfied. After m transactions are read, that is half of the database, that is first two records. So when we read the first two records, a equal to 2, see a equal to 2 times, then b equal to 1, c equal to 0, that is we read the t1 and t2 transaction. A equal to 2, b equal to 1, c equal to 0 and ab equal to 0. Now after the, we are not making ab immediately 1 because we are first converting at the lower level, that is the one item set, into the completion stage. Now here a equal to 2, b equal to 1 and minimum support count is 1. So change a and b to the dash boxes, that is initially it was the circle, dash circle, now we are converting into the dash boxes as they satisfy the minimum support count. And here c is still 0, so we are keeping c as only dash circle. So this is the case when our, when we read the first two transaction. After 2m transaction read, means after the reading the t3 and t4 transaction, so counter becomes a equal to 2, b equal to 2, then c equal to 1. Now see here, still we are making ab, ac and bc 0 because first we set for the one item set and then we are going for the two item set combination. Now you can check that after reading 2m transaction, that is all four transaction, we are getting the fixed count for the a, which is 2. So here dash square is converted into the solid square, b is 2, so dash square is converted into the solid square. Now here c is equal to 1, so c is first initially converted into the dash square and after dash square it is converted into the solid square because its count is 1 and which supports, which satisfy the minimum support count. After that we are making, now this indicates what, a, b, c, that is the elements at the one item set, that is the lower lattice, they satisfy the minimum support criteria. So a and b and c, they satisfy the minimum support criteria. So now we are making their superset as a circle. So here initially a b circle we make, why? Because a and b are the dash square, so whenever they are dash square means what, we require to consider they are the superset. So AB is a dash circle. After the 2M transaction, CS also becomes a confirm, that is satisfy the minimum support count. So the combination of C means what, B, C and AC, we are making the dash circle. After that, after 3M transaction read, so after that we again read the transaction T1, T2. Now we are making the combination of two item set because one item set is going to be, is fixed after 2M transaction. So after 3M transaction means again we read the first two records. So after that we are getting the count for AB as 1, AC 0, BC 0. Now we are converting this AB as a first dash square and after that the solid square because it satisfies the minimum support criteria. Still AC and BC are the circle because they don't satisfy the criteria of minimum support. After 4M transaction reads, means after reading the T3 and T4, so we are getting the combination for BC. So BC is again converted to the solid square as it satisfies the property of, so BC is first converted into dash square and dash square is converted into the solid square. Now what it indicates, that ABC satisfy minimum support, AB is also satisfy the minimum support, BC also satisfy the minimum support. Now after 4M transaction read means what, AC is counted from entire table. So AC count is 0, means it is not present. So whatever that dash circle is converted into the solid circle, but solid circle indicates solid circle indicates confirmed infrequent item set. So this AC is solid circle which represent the confirmed infrequent item set, and there is no problem of ABC. That is, ABC is not converted into the dash circle because AC is not frequent. So AB is frequent, BC is frequent, but AC is not frequent. So all should be must be frequent to mark this ABC as first as a dash circle. So this is nothing but the algorithm. Last method is sampling method. The basic idea is to pick up the random sample S of the given data and then search for the frequent item set in S instead of D. So we are using a very powerful sampling technique which will represent our entire data set, and we are taking, instead of entire data, we are taking the sample from the data. It may possible to lose the global frequent item set. This can be reduced by lowering the minimum support. This is the trade-off of some degree of accuracy against the efficiency, because whenever we take the sample, so it may happen that sometimes the frequent item set may not be captured. So this is nothing but what trade-off of degree of accuracy against efficiency. So these are the various methods in which we can improve the efficiency of a priori algorithm. References are used for this video is from the Hankamber book. The book is third edition, Data Mining Concept and Techniques. Thank you.